Singapore Bank already has a large presence and competes with rivals, including DBS Group and OCBC. IDX Channel reports.
SpaceX requests a launch site for high-speed aircraft in East Kalimantan. Right after the break, market headlines will be back.
IDX First Session Closing Market. Senin sampai Jumat, pukul 11.30, hanya di IDX Channel.
Investor, kalian udah punya rumah belum? Berikut ini adalah tips bagi kalian yang ingin memiliki rumah impian. Tips yang pertama adalah menabung auto debit untuk membayar DP rumah. Kesulitan utama dalam membeli rumah adalah membayar uang muka sebagai syarat KPR. Jadi saat pertama kali kalian menerima gaji, langsung disisikan secara otomatis ya untuk ditabung. Tips yang kedua adalah menabung dalam bentuk tabungan deposito ataupun emas. Menabung dalam bentuk tabungan deposito dan juga emas membuat tabungan kalian menjadi lebih aman dan tentunya melatih kalian agar semakin disiplin dalam menabung. Tips yang ketiga adalah cari DP rumah yang bisa dicicil. Program cicilan DP rumah membantu kalian yang memiliki dana terbatas. Tips berikutnya adalah pilihlah rumah yang sesuai dengan kebutuhan kalian. Pilihlah rumah yang memang kalian butuhkan ya sobat investor. Tips yang terakhir adalah pilihlah KPR dengan tenor yang cukup panjang. Karena KPR dengan tenor yang panjang membuat cicilan bulanan kalian menjadi lebih rendah. Nah, kini memiliki properti impian tentunya bukan angan-angan lagi ya sobat investor.
You're watching Market Headlines. Minister of National Planning and Development or Head of Bappenas, Suharto Monoarfa, say that SpaceX, a US-based space flight company, requested that the new capital city in East Kalimantan provide a launch site for high-speed aircraft. Suharto revealed that the chair of the National Capital Special Committee had come to SpaceX in Los Angeles, America. There they asked one of the points in the capital city in East Kalimantan for a place to launch aircraft with extraordinary speed. He said the request was made because the location of the capital city is right on the equator. By laying the runway, Suharto claimed that a flight from Indonesia to the US only takes less than 2 hours. Previously, the discourse of building a SpaceX rocket launch site echoed early last year. The launch site will be built in Sauko Bie Village, Biak Numfor Regency, Papua, with an area of 1 million square meters. The National Institute of Aeronautics and Space, or LAPAN, which is currently merged into the National Research and Innovation Agency, or BRIN, say that the construction of the SpaceX space airport is still in the initial discussion stage. The Coordinating Ministry for Economic Affairs has prepared a budget of up to 451 trillion rupiah for the National Economic Recovery Program in 2022. This step was taken to revive the economy amid the increasing number of cases of the Omicron variant in Indonesia.
In his presentation at a virtual limited meeting, Coordinating Minister for the Economy Erlangga Hartarto said that the government had prepared a budget of 451 trillion rupiah for the National Economic Recovery Program in 2022. In nominal terms, the budget allocation fell 39.44% compared to last year. Erlangga explained that the funds would be used for three main sectors, including the health sector, the social protection sector, and the fiscal incentive sector.
Pak Presiden juga tadi telah menyetujui beberapa program yang terkait dengan pemulihan ekonomi nasional. Terkait dengan pemulihan ekonomi nasional ini disiapkan anggaran di tahun 2022 sebesar 451 triliun dan itu terbagi menjadi tiga, yaitu untuk kesehatan, perlindungan sosial, dan terkait dengan fasilitas fiskal untuk beberapa sektor ataupun UMKM maupun korporasi.
Erlangga added that later there will be an expansion of social assistance this year, where assistance will be given to 2.76 million people with an assistance of 600,000 rupiah per recipient. In addition, the government also explained the extensions of the value-added tax borne by the government for the property and automotive sector. IDX Channel reports.
The Java-Bali PPKM Coordinator as well as the Coordinating Minister for Maritime Affairs and Investment, Luhut Binsar Panjaitan, predicts that the peak of the Omicron variant of the COVID-19 case in Indonesia will occur in mid-February to early March 2022. This projection reflects on the experience of other countries, including the UK and South Africa, which has passed the peak of Omicron cases. Meanwhile, the government urged the public to continue to apply health protocols and offices, not to apply the 100% work-from-office system. Later, the government will take various mitigation measures so that the increase in cases that occur is more sloping than other countries, so that it does not burden the health system. Luhut assessed that currently the case of local transmission is higher compared to transmissions from international travelers.
Hari ini di Inggris dan Afrika Selatan telah melewati puncak kasus varian Omicron dan negara-negara lainnya juga sudah mulai terlihat tanda-tanda flattening seperti di Amerika Serikat atau Prancis. Nah, hal ini harus kita hindarin. Berdasarkan berbagai data yang telah kami amati, berangkat dari trajectory kasus COVID-19 di Afrika Selatan, puncak gelombang Omicron diperkirakan terjadi pada pertengahan Februari hingga awal Maret ini. Saya ulangi, dari hasil trajectory kasus COVID-19 di Afrika Selatan, puncak gelombang Omicron diperkirakan terjadi pada pertengahan Februari hingga awal Maret ini. Namun, pemerintah akan melakukan berbagai langkah mitigasi agar peningkatan kasus yang terjadi lebih landai dibandingkan dengan negara lain, sehingga tidak membebani.
And meantime, the Ministry of Health predicts a potential spike in cases of the Omicron variant of COVID-19 in the coming weeks. This is based on monitoring the movement of the development of Omicron cases in a number of countries.
The Minister of Health predicts that there will be a potential spike in cases of the Omicron variant of COVID-19 in Indonesia in the coming weeks. This is based on monitoring the development of Omicron cases in a number of countries, which have a time span in the period of increasing cases until they reach their peak. However, the Ministry of Health say the public does not need to panic about the increase in cases. The reason is that the hospitalization of the Omicron variant is considered lower when compared to the previous Delta variant by 30-40%.
Nah, antara 35 sampai 65 hari akan terjadi kenaikan yang cukup cepat dan tinggi. Itu yang memang harus dipersiapkan oleh masyarakat. Yang kedua juga kami sampaikan bahwa sudah terlihat di negara-negara tersebut hospitalisasinya antara 30% sampai 40% dari hospitalisasi Delta. Jadi walaupun kenaikannya lebih cepat dan tinggi, jumlah kasusnya akan lebih banyak dan naik penularannya lebih cepat, tapi hospitalisasi lebih rendah. Sehingga minta tolong dikomunikasikan dengan baik ke seluruh rakyat bahwa nanti kalau ada kenaikan jumlah kasus yang cepat dan banyak, tidak usah panik, kita terus waspada.
Based on government data, to date, there are more than 500 cases of the Omicron variant in Indonesia, of which more than 300 cases have recovered, and only 3 people require oxygen treatment with a mild classification. And for its reason, the Ministry of Health will continue to encourage the acceleration of tracing and testing cases in a number of areas.
IDX Channel reports. During the launching of Indonesian SOE holding in tourism and its supporting, Minister of State-Owned Enterprises Erick Thohir is confident that the assets of holding will reach 260 trillion rupiah in 2024.
Minister of State-Owned Enterprises Erick Thohir is confident that the assets of holding for tourism and supporting SOEs will reach 260 trillion rupiah in 2024. This is in line with potential for increased income. He said the reason for the establishment of this holding was because the government wanted to focus on building domestic tourism. According to Erick, the market potential of tourism sector is still large in Indonesia.
Karena itu kami membentuk holding BUMN Pariwisata dan Pendukung tidak lain, Bapak. Kita ingin memfokuskan bagaimana kesempatan kita untuk membangun dan menciptakan potensi pariwisata domestik yang potensialnya selama ini masih sangat besar tetapi kurang terintegrasi, Bapak. Dan mudah-mudahan, Bapak, kalau dilihat angka-angkanya, nanti total aset daripada holding BUMN ini kurang lebih di tahun 2024 itu 260 juta dengan potensi penjualan yang terus meningkat.
On the same occasion, President Joko Widodo said he would record the target of increasing the assets of holding for tourism and supporting SOEs mentioned by Erick. He hopes that the tourism and supporting SOE holding will make the tourism sector more advanced. In addition, the holding governance is also expected to be more efficient and simpler. IDX Channel report.
Astra International posted significant sales in 2021. Stay tuned on market headlines.
IDX First Session Closing Market. Senin sampai Jumat pukul 11.30 hanya di IDX Channel.
Masih menduga-duga Migran Care ini apa sih?
Migran Care itu NGO, non-governmental organization, yang dibentuk tahun 2004.
Perbincangan bersama sosok wanita yang menginspirasi.
Mendorong pemerintah Indonesia lebih memberikan.
Diulas secara santai dan mendalam.
Gitu ya, untuk pekerja migran kita yang ada di luar negeri yang mereka sering sebut sebagai pahlawan devisa.
Women's Talk. Setiap Jumat pukul 12.30 waktu Indonesia bagian Barat, hanya di IDX Channel. Perbincangan hangat tentang isu dan kebijakan ekonomi terkini yang diulas secara mendalam bersama narasumber terpercaya. Senin sampai Jumat, pukul 10 waktu Indonesia bagian Barat, hanya di IDX Channel.
Kalimat inspirasi.
Perbincangan bersama sosok wanita yang menginspirasi.
Sebenarnya orang adalah orang yang bisa menghormati.
Women's Talk. Setiap Jumat, pukul 12.30 waktu Indonesia bagian Barat, hanya di IDX Channel.
Welcome back on Market Headlines. At the Jakarta Composite Index intraday movement, earlier today, JCI was open at the level of 6,711.4 and then approaching the closing time on the first session, the index was on the level of 6,658.58. And then the index was showing weakening trend by the second session closing time. Index was closed at the level of 6,645.04. And in short, JCI went down 0.72%. And next, we're going to see the sectoral movement leading the dynamics of today's trading. We got energy sector as the leader of strengthening trend that went up 0.49%, and then technology as the leader of weakening trend went down 4.27%, basic sector went down 1.69%, and infrastructure went down 1.05%. And from sectoral movement, let's see the top gainers and top losers. From top gainers, Arto went up 0.4% to the level of 18,650 rupiah per share. Barakyat Indonesia went up 0.72% to the level of 4,210 rupiah per share. Bank Negara Indonesia went up 1.41% to the level of 7,200 rupiah per share. And Amar went up 17.92% to the level of 625 rupiah per share. And meantime, the top losers for today's trading, we got Bank Sentral Asia went down 1.27% to the level of 7,750 rupiah per share. Aneka Tambang went down 4.87% to the level of 1,855 rupiah. Adaro Energy went down 0.44% to the level of 2,260 rupiah. And Bukalapak went down 6.63% to the level of 366 rupiah per share. And let's see the intraday movement of rupiah towards US dollar. Open at the level of 14,321 rupiah, showing weakening trend towards US dollar. And it was closed at the level of 14,328. And in summary, rupiah went down 0.32%. Sales of Astra International grew more than 80% throughout 2021. Meanwhile, Astra targets a market share of at least 50% in 2022.
Supported by improving economic conditions and government policies, sales of Astra International grew significantly throughout 2021. Meanwhile, throughout 2021, Astra managed to record car sales of 489,000 units in 2021. The sales realization increased by 81.14% from the previous year, which was 270,000 units. LCGC car sales also shot up 56.68% to 114,000 units in 2021, from 72,000 units in the period 2020. According to Astra International's Head of Corporate Communications, Boy Klana Subroto, throughout 2021, Astra national car sales recorded very good growth compared to sales in 2020. This is influenced by several factors, especially the luxury goods VAT incentive, which was extended until the end of last year. Astra looks optimistically at the automotive industry in 2022. The company also targets a market share of at least 50%. Astra hopes that the car market in 2022 will improve in line with the moving wheels of the economy and the increasing purchasing power of the people. IVX Channel reports.
PTPP is targeting the acquisition of new contracts of 31 trillion rupiah in 2022, or 54% higher than achievement in 2021.
PTPP is targeting the acquisition of new contracts of 31 trillion rupiah in 2022. PTPP Corporate Secretary Yuyus Juwarsa said the acquisition of new contracts is targeted to come from the building sector with a value of 34.56%, roads and bridges by 30.95%, industry by 11.29%, oil and gas by 7.9%. Yuyus Juwarsa explained that in 2022, PTPP will also focus on working on government-owned and state-owned Pareto projects. Meanwhile, PTPP's total marketing segmentation for projects owned by the government, state-owned enterprises, and state-owned company reached 92%. PTPP has developed various strategies and policies to achieve the targets that have been set in 2022. In addition, the strategies prepared for the short, medium, and long term are carried out to maintain business continuity and increase sustainable financial performance growth. IDX Channel reports.
Indica Energy has allocated a capital expenditure of $193 million, or equivalent to 2.75 trillion rupiah this year. This capital expenditure will be used for the development of subsidiaries. Indica Energy's Head of Corporate Communications, Ricky Fernando, explained that most of this year's capital expenditure will be used by its subsidiary, namely Petrosea and Gold Mining Development, through its business entity, Masmindo Dwi Area. Through this capital expenditure, Indica hopes to achieve this year's production target. Ricky explained that this year, Indica targets Kideco Jaya Agung's production of 34 million tons and Multi Tambang Jaya Utama's 1.8 million tons this year. In addition to boosting existing businesses, Indica is also developing businesses outside of coal. The business development are in the fields of gold mining, nature-based solutions, and new and renewable energy. And stepping aside from market condition, as the efforts in achieving herd immunity is still going on, here it is, an update data about COVID-19 vaccinations in Indonesia. And the news close our market headlines today. Please enjoy our next program on IDX channel, your trustworthy economic, business and capital market channel. I'm Fajar Wayong. Have a nice evening. Stay healthy.